dress drops over my bulletproof vest, sports bra over black mesh, restricts buckle bulges. The vest's bulky bulge further puffs flaring skirt. Meant to hold guns, I suppose. I don't want to take a life. I want to live.
A witch in Gilead.
I bought this bulletproof vest instead of a gun.
In the end times.
In the dark days before the 2018 midterm election. The third civil war is on. A shadow war. Battled in the streets. Online. Through cyber warfare. By Antifa. Russian spies. The resistance. Proud Boys. People of color. Activists. Anarchists. The manosphere. The alt-right. And the witches. The magic resistance. Loose coalitions for those for and against white supremacy. When waxes in November to a full beaver moon. I'm on my period. Carefully pouring my full pixie menstrual cup of my own womb blood into a vanilla extract bottle. The vanilla extract hides the caramel scent. Herpes womb blood, the powerful ingredient from my arsenal. The magic resistance requires balls to the wall commitment. It's on. The Reno Gazette Journal reports a local shooting every single day. I will not die like a lemming in the rain of bullets to come. October 1st is my birthday. October 1st, 2017, a rain of bullets hit the Mandalay Bay Casino in Las Vegas. Massacre. PTSD beats into my mind that if something happens a few times, like rapes or attempts on my life, or mass shootings, they could always happen again at any time. I cower inside my house with the rising sun. Refuse to make local friends, family only. Like the mafia, but without all that crime. I lunch with my father's Republican friends. The wife makes no secret of the pistol she's packing in her purse. I write her off. Gun ownership and gun carrying is a deal breaker in friendship, romance, or even sharing your life space. Take steps to protect myself. I want to feel safe in this biggest little outside that may never be possible. Be prepared. Chant the Girl Scouts of my youth. Dawn, the morning of the election. No invasive canvassers about. I calibrate warmth with safety to take out the trash. Hair triggered as a Vietnam vet. Were it not for my family, I would be sobbing on a cot in a shelter right now, because of my illnesses. Colonizer inherited blood money keeps disabled me alive. Aware of this paradox,
to live seems evil,
yet imperative. To commit suicide over the myriad wrongs of the past, unpalatable, messy, and no more likely than the improbable mass suicide of this whole demographic. In between my social conscience and my own brute will to survive, one life. To dance to this electro hit in clubs in Los Angeles under Obama when I could still dance freely with abandon. My November 2018 playlist is every remix of this song on Spotify. Anthem. I pull a gray sweater dress down over the bulletproof vest. Button a sensible cardigan. Pull up red knee socks. All with a buttery gray leather trench coat. Perfect old lady drag. Down to the butt. Fake paunch. Taking out the trash and the chill air as a breeze. Looking like this. Thanksgiving morning. I try the green dress on over my bulletproof vest again. We have a no politics at the dinner table, but I know everyone else other than sober me will be drinking. I really doubt my own family would shoot me, but do you read the news? It happens all the time, especially at holidays, especially in Nevada, where even I, who am certifiably insane, could get a gun if I waltzed into Cabela's, smooth talking with enough cash. PTSD is not being able to trust even those most nearest and dearest to me. After party era, a man I was engaged to tried to slit my throat. LaRue era. A man I was engaged to, a different one, tried to strangle me to death. Had there been a gun on either bedside table? If I let my bipolar rage out of the cage at dinner, uttered the ugly, genocidal truth behind our mocking merrymaking, all bets are off. Anything can happen nowadays. It is terrifying to live like this. It is terrifying to live in this mind, in this body,
in these times. A Vegas con man says to a princess on the Royals, "You have to trust somebody sometime."
His words echo in my mind. The vest's Velcro scratches my back of raw. I'm never able to wear this thing for longer than 10 minutes. A 5-hour consistent same outfit dinner would be torture. Such a bold defensive move is offensively excessive to my family and to my own sense of trust in the world. I re-grasp reality, climb out of PTSD psychosis, take off the bulletproof vest, set it on a shelf in my closet, leave it behind till the third Civil War actually does beat a path to my door. Try, with all my will, to trust the family that I love, not to pack heat on this festive occasion of Thanksgiving. The love of my extended family is real. They want to feed me, laugh with me, not kill me, as they always have.